This video is sponsored by Unity. Making games is awesome. It's such a fun and creative process. You dream up whole new worlds, characters, and mechanics and make them happen. And in the end, you create something that others can enjoy. And that's a wonderful feeling. But how can you actually start making games and learn all the necessary skills and tools? I get this question a lot, and to be honest, it's a tough one. But today, I'm gonna show you a way to get started, and most importantly, where to start. Okay, I'm gonna assume that you don't have any programming knowledge and you've never touched the game making software either. Games are usually made in specialized softwares called game engines. These softwares, for example Unity, Unreal, Godot, Game Maker and so on, do the heavy lifting when you are developing a game. They handle most of the complicated stuff like lighting, rendering, physics, so you can focus on the actual logic and mechanics of your game. And this is a huge thing because most of the scary stuff that would require advanced skills, you don't have to touch. Let's get into it. The first step is to install a game engine. I've already installed Unity, but you can get it from unity.com by hitting get started. There's even a handy guide that helps you get set up with everything you'll need. But I don't want to bore you, so let's move on to the second step, which is to get a bit familiar with Unity's interface. There are multiple options here, so you can choose the one that suits you the best. You can go ahead with the interactive tutorials that Unity provides in the editor. They are called microgames and they are like example projects, but with step-by-step tutorials that help you modify these games to create your own versions of them. Currently, there are three different microgames: an FPS, a 2D platformer microgame, and a kart racing game. If you skip the installation guide and you don't have a microgame as your first project in Unity, then you can access them in the Unity Hub under the Learn tab. These microgames will be perfect to teach you the basics, for example, different windows, manipulating objects, and in general make you a bit comfortable in the editor. You will find the very first tutorials in the editor, and the rest is on learn.unity.com. But if you prefer a bit more passive way of learning, because you're lazy like me, then you might like tutorial videos more. You can easily pick up the necessary knowledge on the editor from them. And the main goal is to get the general idea of the editor, so don't worry about not understanding every single bit. I'm gonna point out a few materials, but you can always get more by searching Unity Basics, Unity Beginner on YouTube. And there's also a dedicated page for beginners at unity.com, that you might find useful. The link is in the description. But here are a few materials I think could be good to start with. This one is a playlist on the very basics of Unity, and it's using the microgames that I've mentioned. It's made by Matt from Unity. And there's another pretty good series from a fellow YouTuber, Brackies, on making a simple game. This one is a bit longer and can get you up to a higher level. It's a few years old, but it shouldn't be a problem in this case. And if you really want to kickstart your learning, Unity has a Grow Your Skills Mega Bundle sale right now, which not only contains a bunch of awesome assets worth over $1,000, but also contains 1 year long access to Unity's official online learning platform called Unity Learn Premium. Unity Learn Premium has a wide range of learning materials, so you can build your game dev expertise. I found a lot of good beginner content like importing 2D assets, introduction to tiremaps, and creating basic UI. Also, there's a pretty neat and extensive course on C# called Unity C# Survival Guide, which teaches you how to code in Unity. But whether you are an experienced game developer or just starting out, Unity Learn Premium has over 500 tutorials in structured learning paths at every level to help you upskill and reach your goals. And as I mentioned before, this Grow Your Skills Mega Bundle also contains a lot of awesome assets, like 3D models to create your own levels, even skyboxes to have your own galaxies, lots of amazing effects, and tools like Playmaker if you're planning to make a game without coding, and InControl to handle all sorts of controller inputs with ease. So check out the Grow Your Skills Mega Bundle, the link is in the description, and kickstart your game development journey with awesome assets and high quality learning materials. And thanks to Unity for supporting this channel. Okay, after you spent like a day or two learning the very basics of the Unity editor, it's time to start making games. Yep, you've heard me right, Because game development is very broad, with a lot of fields, topics, tools, it's easier to just start making games and learn the skills when you need them. So what I would suggest is to look around and find a few tutorials on certain mechanics you find interesting and combine them to create a simple game. By repeating this process, you'll end up knowing how to implement a bunch of mechanics, and also you won't just watch and read tutorials, you'll use them, practice them, thus they will stick way better. And of course you'll end up with a bunch of games, which is awesome. These simple games you're gonna make will contain a few bits of code, and they might be scary at first, but keep in mind you don't have to fully understand everything for the first time. And you can always look up tutorials on coding in Unity, or just search for the things you see in the code to figure out what they do exactly. And don't think that simple games require a lot of coding. You can get by using very little. My first game was a top-down game where you had to move the cursor from point A to point B on platforms. You lose if you go off the platforms, and to make it difficult, certain platforms were moving. You know what, I'm gonna recreate this game and I'm gonna pretend I know nothing but the basics of Unity. I'll only use stuff that I find in tutorials and I'll combine them together to create this game. This is actually a pretty neat challenge. So what's the first thing we'll need? We need to figure out how we even start to make a 2D game in Unity, right? So let's just search Unity 2D game setup on YouTube and just go through the results. This one, simple 2D scene setup from CodeMonkey, looks promising, so let's just check it out. He starts off showing us how to set up a 2D scene. And after that, he shows us that the basic building blocks of a 2D game are sprites. So he's making a background by creating a game object and adding a sprite renderer to it. Okay, let's do the same. I'm gonna create an empty game object, name it background, and add a sprite renderer to it. Now he's using a 1x1 white pixel image to render something on the screen. That's clever, but how can we get an image like that? I don't know, let's search on Google for that. I'm too lazy to open up a graphics software to create one. 1x1 white pixel image. Cool, there are actual sites you can download one pixel. Let's just click the 1x1 white preset and download. And I'm gonna save it to the assets folder. And here it is. So he's doing what next? Oh, he's setting the pixel per unit to 1. Okay, let's do that. Hit apply. Next, he's dragging and dropping it into the sprite field. So background, 1 pixel, and bam. There's our beautiful pixel. That's good. Oh, and we can change its color and size. Nice. It's pretty much enough to create our own levels, but let's keep watching a bit. Now he's talking about sorting layers and sorting orders so that the background won't be in front of the player covering it. Cool. Let's create our own sorting layers. One for the background, another one for the platforms, and the final one for the zones. The rest of his video is covering other stuff that we don't need right now, but feel free to watch the rest. And actually, his channel is pretty good if you want to get into coding. Link is in the description. Okay, now we can place colorful rectangles on the screen. That's pretty much enough to create our first level. We need a few platform pieces, a start zone and a finish zone. With Ctrl-D or Command-D on Mac, I can duplicate the selected game object. Now we have to figure out how to detect when the cursor leaves the platforms. It would be perfect if we had something that tells us if the cursor is hovering over the background. So let's just search for Unity check if mouse is over a sprite. I searched on Google instead of YouTube because I think this problem is a bit too specific. And I don't think that someone has made a video on this problem exactly, but I'm pretty sure someone has asked this question already. Let's see. Detect when the mouse is over a sprite 2D. Well, that sounds good. Mm-hmm. On mouse enter, here's a little piece of code as well. And he says it works fine after adding colliders. Okay, but what's a collider? I don't know, I'm no expert. Let's find a tutorial for that. Unity Collider. It's enough to just skim through a video like this to get the general idea and to how to use colliders. In his video, he just selected the game object, and in the inspector window, he just hit add component and went for either a box collider 2D or a circle collider 2D. So let's do the same for our background game object. We'll select it and add a box collider 2D to it. Now we somehow have to use that one line of code we found to check if the cursor is hovering over the background. But where to add the script? So let's search again. Unity, script, basics. Charger games. This video is a bit long because coding is a huge topic, but we only need to figure out how to add a script to a game object. And here it is. We just need to create a new C# script and drag and drop it on the game object. So let's create our custom script and drag and drop it on the background game object, either in the inspector or in the hierarchy window. We need to open it up and paste that one line of code we found previously. Let's save it and try it out. Awesome! It prints out a message in the console window every single time the mouse hovers over the background game object, which covers the whole screen in this case. We can change the message by modifying the line. So let's change it to game over and save the script. Now it says game over. Cool. If we cover our background's collider with other colliders to create the platforms, then our game won't say game over when we hover over the platforms. So let's just add colliders to the platform game objects. It kinda works, most of the time, because some of the platforms doesn't cover the background properly. But that's life. You'll face a lot of problems in your game dev journey. In these cases, try to figure out what's the problem, and if you can't fix it, just go to Google or forums and search until you find a solution. Try to rephrase your questions or keywords from time to time, and if you can't find answers, just ask. There are a lot of cool people in the community who will be happy to help you out. I figured my issue out after some trial and error. I just had to move the background in the Z-axis a bit further from the camera, and after that it was working fine. Now we only need to create another script so we can print out a good job message when the cursor reaches the finish zone. It's gonna be the same as the background script, but with a different message. And let's add the script to the finish game object. And we should move this finish game object closer to the camera, just to be sure. And that's it. We've made a very simple game prototype. From here, we can just continue our learning by adding moving and rotating platforms and prettifying the graphics a bit. And don't forget to create more levels. That's the fun part. It wasn't that difficult, right? Well, sometimes it will be and you'll be stuck for days, but that's how it goes. Don't give up. What I would suggest is to do not lock yourself into a game idea and struggle on it for weeks. Instead, go the other way around. Find a few interesting tutorials and build a game around that. Limitations drive creativity and can lead you to amazing results. And don't forget that real learning comes from doing it. You will know a lot of stuff if you create a few simple games. Good luck on your journey, and most importantly, have fun. Huge thanks to all the awesome Patreon supporters. Don't forget to subscribe and check out my Bowhand series where I'm creating a game from scratch. See you next time!